बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम। अस्सलाम वालेकुम माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स। स्टूडेंट्स, विदाउट मैथमेटिक्स देयर इज नथिंग यू कैन डू। एवरीथिंग अराउंड यू इज मैथमेटिक्स एंड एवरीथिंग अराउंड यू इज नंबर्स। सो दिस इज ऑल अबाउट द इम्पोर्टेंस ऑफ द नंबर्स एंड मैथमेटिक्स। सो टुडे here Miss Rida Asif with you, your maths teacher, and with me who are going to start a new chapter, chapter number 5, fractions. Do you know what is a fraction? A fraction is a number that describes the relationship between a part and a whole. A part and a whole. What does it mean? For example, here you can see the shape here. This shape is whole shape given to you. If I divide this whole shape in 4 equal parts like this, if I divide this whole shape in 4 equal parts, and then if I take one part from it, okay, if I take one part from it, I can say that this is 1/4. That is, I have taken the quarter part. Okay, if I have taken 2 parts, okay, then I can say that 2/4. In the same way, if I take the 3 parts, if I take 3 parts from these 4 parts, then I can say 3/4. Okay, and if I take this 4th part also, then I can say 4/4. 4 ones are 4 and 4 ones are 4, that is equals to 1. That means that I have taken the whole shape over there. Clear? 1/4, 2/4, 3/4, these all are called the fractions, where 1, 2, 3 are the numerator. Okay? Or we can say that it's a part. Okay? The part which I have taken from the whole. I have taken the part from the whole. So the part must be written in the numerator. Okay, this is called the numerator, and the whole must be written in the denominator. This is called your denominator. So how many types of fractions are there? There are 3 types of fractions: proper fraction, improper fraction, and mixed fraction. Do you know about these types of fractions? Improper fraction, the numerator, that means the number which is written at the top, is smaller. That means 1/3. 1 is a smaller. 5 is a smaller than 8. So these are the example of proper fraction. When the numerator is greater than the denominator, it is called the improper fraction. Okay? When the numerator is smaller, it is called proper. When it is greater, when the numerator is greater, then it is called the improper fraction. Okay? Now the third one is mixed number. Mixed number means whole number plus a fraction. Okay? Whole number and a fraction. Here 3 whole number, 5/7. Here the whole number is also there and the fraction is also there. So this is called a mixed number, okay? Because 2 types of numbers are mixed over there, so it is called a mixed number. Okay, my dear? Okay, here one thing which I want to tell you, that whenever you are getting the answer in improper fraction, then you have to convert it in mixed fraction, okay? Clear? Whenever the answer is an improper fraction, comes in improper fraction, we have to convert it in mixed fraction. Okay, otherwise your marks will be deducted for that. What about the decimal fractions? Now look at the definition carefully. A fraction where the denominator is a power of 10. Denominator means the number which is written in the bottom. Okay? Is a power of 10. Such as 10, 100, 1000. This is called the decimal fraction. For example, my dear, 7 upon 10. Here the denominator is 10. 43 over 100. Here the denominator is 100. Whenever the denominator is represented with 10, 100, 1000, 10,000, it can be say that it is a decimal fraction. It is a decimal fraction. Clear? Whenever the denominator is a power of 10, it is called the decimal fraction. Now you can write this decimal fraction with a decimal point. Okay? That means without any denominator. Why you can write in this way? Because it makes it easier for the calculations like addition, multiplication on fraction. Okay? Why we are doing it so? To make our simplification easier. Okay? How can we convert 7 upon 10 in decimal? How can we convert this decimal fraction? How can we remove this denominator and how can we place the decimal point? Okay, if the denominator is 10, that means 10 is over there. When 10 is over there, if 10 is over there, then the decimal is going to be moved one place. So we get 0.7. Okay? If in the denominator 2 zeros are over there, then we have to place the decimal just before 2 number. That means here. Okay? If we are having 3 zeros, so we have to move the decimal before 3 numbers. But here only 2 numbers are there. So we have to put the 0. Then we have to put the decimal over here. We get 0.043. Correct? 0.043. Yes, Vanya? You are asking me something? Now, how can we convert the decimal into fraction? Okay, in this, I told you that how can we convert the fraction into decimal point. Now here, we are going to discuss that if 0.8 is given to you, how can we convert it in decimal fraction? Okay. Vanya, you were raising your hand. Is there any problem? So, my dear. Point 0.8 is over there. Okay, Vanya. So, point 0.8 is over there. That means here the decimal is before one number. So, here I have to put 10 with 1. It becomes 8 upon 10. Okay? 8 upon 10. Right? Now, it can be further simplified. 2 4s are 8 and 2 5s are 10. So we get the answer 4 over 5. Now how can we convert this number? Students, here 4 is written before the decimal. So just write down 4 as it is. Now point is written before one number. Here the decimal point is just before one number. So again I have to put 10 with 1. It becomes 2 upon 10. Okay? 2 upon 10. For example, if the decimal is over there, if the decimal is placed before 4, then I have to write 42 upon 100. Clear, everybody? Then I have to write 42 over 100. But here, decimal is written between them. So 4 will be written as it is, and we get 2 upon 10. Now for the further simplification, after we get 2 ones are 2 and 2 fives are 10, like this. Now here in this question, 5 will be copied as it is. Now the decimal is before two numbers. Before two numbers, that is 1 and 2. Two numbers are there. So I have to put 2 zeros with 1. 12 upon 100. Here we get 12 upon 100. Why? Because the decimal is just before two numbers. So after simplification, 4 threes are 12 and 4 25s are 100. We get 5 whole number 3 over 25. Now let's discuss some more question. Change the following into common fraction. Now here the decimal fractions again given to you. Here the decimal is just before. Here the decimal point is just before one number. So we get 15 whole number 3 over 10. We cannot further simplify it. Okay. Now for example, if the decimal is placed before two numbers, that means two numbers are there after decimal, then we have to write 100 in the denominator. What we have to do? We have to write 100 in the denominator. Are you getting me? Two numbers are there, so we have to write 100. If one number is over there, then we have to write one number in the denominator. Clear, everybody? Bitte, we cannot further simplify it. So this is the answer. Okay? Now, the question is 0.376. Now here, there are three numbers after decimal. That means three zeros must be there. Okay? Three zeros must be there. 376 over 1000. Now, it can be simplified like this. Two ones are 2. One left over here. Two eights are 16. One again left. Two eights are 16. We get 188. Now, two fives are 10. 0 and 0. Okay? The simplification is going to be done with the table of 2. Yes, Ramesa, are you getting me? Okay. Now, again, we can simplify it. Bete, again, this is the even numbers you can see. So, we can again simplify it. Two nines are 18. Two fours are 8. Now, in the denominator, Sumaya, look at the denominator. 500. Two twos are 4. One left. Two fives are 10. And 0 will be copied as it is. Now, again, you can simplify it. You get 47 over 125, right? 47 over 125. Now, we cannot further simplify it. So, this is our answer. Okay? Now, the next question is change the following into decimal fraction. Now, students, look at the questions carefully. Afra, are you there with me? Afra, are you getting me? Now, 1 upon 5. The question is 1 upon 5. Clear, everybody? If the question is 1 upon 5, we have to convert this fraction into decimal fraction. Now, look at the simplification carefully. But in such type of question, we have to convert the denominator. We have to convert the denominator with 10, with 100, with 1000. Why? Because we need the decimal fraction. We have to convert the fraction into decimal fraction. And we know that decimal fraction means that having the denominator 10, 100, 1000. Am I right? Am I right? That means we need in the denominator 10, 100 and 1000. So 5 is over there. How 5 can be converted into 10? If we multiplied it with 2. So here we are going to multiply and divide it with 2. Clear? So 2 ones are 2 and 2 fives are 10. 2 fives are 10. Okay? So we get 2 upon 10. We get the in the denominator 10. That means it's our decimal fraction. Okay? Now, how can we place the decimal point, bete? If there is 1 zero, then I have to, what I have to do? If there is only 1 zero in the denominator, then the decimal will be placed over here. 1 zero hai, so we have to move the decimal to one place. Agar 2 zeros hai, to 2 places move karayenge, like this. All right? Clear everybody? We get the answer 0.2. If 100 is over there, then we get the answer 0.02. Right? If 3 zero over there, we get 0.002. There? So, what about the next question, my dear? Here, in the next question, we get the question 6 whole number 1 over 2. So, it's a mixed number. Write 6 as it is. 6 plus 1 over 2. We can write this 6 whole number 1 upon 2 like this. 6 plus 1 upon 2. Okay? 6 whole number plus 1 over 2. Now, how can we convert this 1 upon 2, this 1 upon 2 in the decimal fraction? Now, 2 will going to be multiplied with 5. If I multiply 2 with 5, then I can get 10 in the denominator. So, let's multiply and divide it with 5. Okay? Why we are doing so? Because 2 fives are 10. Okay? So, 6 whole number plus 5 ones are 5 and 2 fives are 10. 6 whole number 5 over 10. Clear everybody? Now, 5 upon 10 means we have to move the decimal to one place. So, we get 0.5. We get 0.5. Like 0.2, we get 0.5. 6 plus 0 is 6 and we get 6.5 as an answer. Okay? We get 6.5. Now, let's take one more example to make your concept clear. My dear student, here again, there is a mixed fraction given to you. Again, there is a mixed fraction given to you. Abdullah Ishtiaq, are you getting me? Abir Khan, Fatma Nadeem. Is there any question, my dear? Bete, here, mixed fraction is given to you. Okay, mixed fraction. Now, what you have to do in the first step, you have to write 14 whole number 2 upon 5. Okay, 14 whole number plus 2 over 5. Now, here 5 is there. Okay, in the denominator, 5 is there. That means you have to multiply, divide it with 2. You have to multiply and divide it with 2 to get 5 twos are 10. Okay, to get 5 twos are 10. What do you have to do? You have to just check out the denominator. Okay, you have to just check out the denominator. If there is 2, you have to multiply it with 5. If there is 5, you have to multiply it with 2. So you get 2 twos are 4 and 5 twos are 10. Clear? Now 10, again 10 is over there. So you have to move one place before the, you have to move the decimal just one place. You get 0.4. 14 plus 0, we get 14.4. Now let's discuss how can we round off to two places after decimal. Okay, my dear? Let's discuss. Omar, now my voice is clear. Now, bete, the question is 1.687. The number which is given to you, 1.687. You have to round off to two places after decimal. Now, remember, there are three steps. How many steps? There are three steps. Step number one, draw a line to the right of the second decimal place. Where? Here you can see that this, there is a decimal place. There is a decimal point. What you have to do, you have to draw the line where after two numbers of decimal. 1, 2. Here you have to place the line. Okay, this is a step number one. Now, in step number two, you have to check that whether this number is 5 or bigger. 7. 7 is bigger than 5. 7 is bigger than 5. Yes. If yes, then you have to round up. What does it mean? If this third number is bigger than 5, then what you have to do? You have to add one number here. So 8 plus 1 will become 9. We get the answer 1.69. Okay? If the number is 5 or greater than 5, you have to round up. You have to round up the second number. You have to round up the second number. But if this number is not greater than 5, for example, here, the number is less than 5, 3 is there, then we have to round down. Round down means we are not going to add any number here in the second place. Okay, so we get the answer 1.68. Again, for example, we have the question 1.684. Again, the third number is less than 5. Then again, the answer will be same. We have to round down. Now here, for example, the number is 2.781. We have to round off to two places after decimal. Okay. This one is less than 5. That means we have to round down. What we have to do? We have to round down. So by removal of this one, we are not going to add any number with 8. So it becomes 2.78. We are rounding down. When the third number is greater than 5, okay? When the number is 5 or greater than 5, then this number is going to be rounded up. It will become 0.82. We are going to add one number and the second place after decimal. Now let's consider some more examples. For example, here students, the question is 6.789. 6.789. Okay, there is three numbers after decimal. So first of all, put the line. Okay, after putting the line, you can see that this number is greater. This number is greater than 5. Okay? If the number is 5 or greater than 5, what we have to do? We have to round up. So we get 6.79. We have added one number in 8. Now, if in the question only one number is there after decimal, and if we need two numbers after decimal, what we can do with it? We can simply add 0 with 5. Okay? We get 221.50. Why we are doing it so? Because we have to round off to two places. We need two places. So you can simply put 0 with 5. Okay? Now question number 3. There are three numbers after decimal. How many numbers are there, Fatma? There are three numbers. Okay? So here you have to put a line over there. Now, my dear, let me properly explain this question to you over here. Zainab, look at this question carefully. If this 9 becomes 0, okay, what we have to do? We have to remove the third number. Na? So if we remove this third number, we have to add 1. Why? Because we are rounding up. By adding one number with 9, it becomes 10. So we get 0. Okay? 0 here and 1 over there. So 1 plus 9, again 10, 0 is going to be written there. 1 is going to be written over here. So point, we have to place the point over there. So 1 plus 0 becomes 1. Okay. So 8 will be copied as it is. 7 will be copied as it is. So we get the answer 781.00. Okay. Or simply we can say that 781. 781. Now, I hope that all the questions are properly clear to you. Yes, Abir? Everything is clear? So now it's my turn to ask the questions. Ready, everybody? Good, Halima. So question number one. Do as directed, 251.3. This is the decimal fraction. What you have to do? You have to change into common fraction. You have to change into common fraction. Yes. Abdullah Ishtiaq, share your answers in the chat box quickly. I want this answer from you. Quickly share your answers. I want you all to share your answers quickly. Abdullah, quickly solve the questions. Yes, Aisha. Yes, Sumaya. Quickly. Here I'm noting down the names of the students. Always respond me. So the first answer is given by Halima. Very good. And by Rumessa, we get the answer 251, 3 over 10. Excellent, my dear. No, Abhi. Bete, the decimal is placed before one number. Okay, so I have to place 10 in the denominator. Clear? I have to place 10. Clear or not? What happened, Vanya, Fatma? Share your answers quickly, bete. Very good. Again, Halima has given me the answer 4.5. Very good, Halima. Very good. What about the question number 3? Here. I've got the answer by Zena and by Sumaya. Okay. We get the answer 0.81. Very good, Bitte Zainab. You are absolutely correct. We have to round up. Okay. We have to round up because the third number is 9. The third number is 9. So we have to add one number with 0. It becomes 0.81. Clear, Sumaya? Is it clear? Clear, everybody? Okay. Now moving on to the next question. Change the following into common fraction. The question is 1.29. We have to remove the decimal. And by removal of the decimal, we get 100,000 in the denominator. So we get the answer. What a quick response given by Halima. Excellent, bete. So the answer number one is one whole number 29 upon 100. So let's see who is going to give me the answer of question number two first. I'm just waiting for the response. Again, the answer is given by Halima. But there is one more step, okay? My voice is not clear. Abdullah, my voice is not clear. Students, my voice is not clear. Can you please tell me? Sumaya, there must be one more step. Halima and Sumaya, there must be one more step. Abdullah, but you can share your answers with me. You are not sharing your answers. One over five. Very good. Okay. Simplification step is missing. So we get 78 whole number, but five ones are five and five twos are 10. Okay. Not one upon five, 78 whole number, one upon two. Okay. Yes, yes, you're right. Now, here, change the following into decimal fraction. Here, the question is 3 over 4. Now, I want you all to solve this question and I want answer from each and every student. Is it clear, Noseba? Is it clear, Afra? Fatma? Okay? What do you have to do? You have to change the denominator. You have to change the denominator with tens, hundred and thousand. You have to multiply four with such a number that it becomes 10, 100 or 1000. Okay? So try to solve this question. In the same time, I'm going to show you your today's assignment, everybody. Okay? Ready? So here is the assignment I'm going to show you. Here is the assignment on your screen. Look at the assignment carefully, everybody. This is lecture 16, assignment number 14. You have to do this assignment in your maths copy, okay? You have to do this assignment in your maths copy. This is a new chapter. So properly in the index, please write down the heading of chapter number 5, fractions. Here, properly maintain your index with the serial number, with date, and properly mention this index. Okay? Here, mention question 1. I have already mentioned the question and the bit numbers. You have to solve these questions. The questions are given on the page number 93. Okay? On page number 93, these questions are given to you. In this chapter, we are going to do this exercise 5.3 only, okay? So in this exercise 5.3, you have to attempt today these three questions, okay? And these bits are given to you. Bete, please properly note down the bit number, okay? Now here are the marks division of these questions. Every bit containing one mark. If you attempt the wrong bit, you will lose your mark. Okay? Now, here I have written that you have to attempt these questions in maths copy. Again, I'm telling you. Now, very important that you have to prepare chapter 3 algebra from the exercise 3.1, 3.3 and 3.4. Okay? For the class test 1 that is conducted on 24 August 2020. And you have to learn these tables. Now, for your help, how can you solve these questions? The example questions are given to you for question 1, for question 2, and for question number 3 as well. Okay. You can check out these questions. You can check out the lecture again. You can, for solving your assignment, keep these questions in front of you if you are having any problem. Okay. Is it clear? But please, these questions are given for your guidance. Okay. You can just take a look at these example questions. And what you have to do, you have to solve the assignment which is given over here. Is there any question, my dear? Related to the assignment, is there any question, Halima? Is there any question? Yes, Iraj, where were you? No, Seba, is there any question regarding to this assignment? Properly, this assignment is clear? Now, moving back to our lecture, we were discussing this question 3/4. Okay? We were discussing this question. I want you all to prepare yourself for the CT properly, Bete. It will be conducted on 24th August. Okay? So we get the answer. We get the answer by Afra, Niseba, Abdullah, and okay. So we get the answer here. 4 will be multiplied by 25. Okay. So 3 25s are 75 and 4 25s are 100. Okay. And then it will be converted into 0.75. Very good. I hope today's lecture is clear to you. My dear, the only way to learn mathematics is to do mathematics. Am I right? So just take care of yourself and properly complete your assignments. And Allah Hafiz, my dear.